we look around and look at the aesthetics and look at everything, it's really real. To get to Bro Solo real quick, when I worked at UPS for a short time and coming across a lot of cats that are in microclubs, and they asked me about Allstar Radio, and I said, look, Legacy Internet Radio every Thursday. Check them out. I don't get a chance to listen to everything, but when I do get a chance to listen, you know, brothers have information. So it's kind of like brothers that are in biker clubs, look, check these brothers out. It's nothing silly. It's nothing off the wall. They got some great information right there. And so, and bringing that back to the forefront as far as Legacy Internet Radio in and of itself, with Legacy Media, TV, all of the above. Keep growing, keep progressing, because if anything, it is reminding us when we talk about empowerment, man, it's powerful.
Appreciate you, brother. And you know, I have Steph on Mark and Jay Bach from Den Legacy Internet Radio. Give a special shout out to our sister, the First Lady of Legacy Internet Radio. Media SSP, she's in the room a little while ago. We don't have her right now, but I can tell you, she's a big part of what we do here. It's difficult for us to go forward with a lot of the plans and the things that we do at Legacy Internet Radio because she's an integral part of our think tank. And so I wanted to make sure that, along with giving everyone their flowers, I made sure that I gave her the biggest bouquet because, you know, we couldn't do a lot of what we do around here without the First Lady of Legacy Internet Radio, so I wanted to make sure I gave her some love. And I have Stella Marks J live from the Den Legacy Internet Radio, which is now part of Legacy Media Group. We're going to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to do a little bit of what we do here on the show. We're going to start some controversy, and we're going to talk some trash. Who's up on the docket? You already know. Does this man know Putin? Does the President of the United States know Putin? We'll play a little clip on the other side of his break. And we're going to let you listen to him say whether he knows Vladimir Putin in his own words, and then we're going to talk about it. I got the entire crew. I got live action captions, my brother Sid. I got Taku. I got Dee Dee. I got Nigni. I got Solo, the big old Joe, yours truly, Marcus J, and you, the crew. We will be back in a few. Back, y'all. relationship.
That's known very well because we were back 60 minutes. We were stable nights, so we did very well that night. We did 60 minutes together, by the way, not together together. You know, he was brother who shot in Moscow.
You know, I was in Moscow a couple of months ago. I owned the Miss Universe pageant. And they treated me so good. Putin even sent me a present, beautiful present, with a beautiful bow. I spoke to all of his people.
I spoke indirectly and directly with President Putin, who could not have been nicer.
I don't know Putin. I have no idea. I never met Putin.
Have you met Vladimir Putin?
Yes.
Putin.
Okay, well, thanks for clearing that up. So now we...
Hi, I'm Jimmy Kimmel. If you like that, click the subscribe button below, and good things will happen forever.
And I have stuff that I wanted to say about the Dent Legacy Internet Radio. So, we got a lot of questions that we need to ask. We need to ask them of our president, and we're going to ask them of each other. So, we're going to get the crew back in. Start with you, Taku. Donald Trump is president of the United States. I don't know if you voted for him. I do know that I did not. And I am very concerned about the direction of our country because the election of Donald Trump has put a large portion of our country at odds with the other portion of our country. And the people who are screaming, lock her up, lock her up, lock her up, are largely the same people who want to wait out the Russia thing and see how it goes, as opposed to seeing little bits and pieces of evidence as it begins to come out. Let me just lay a couple of those pieces of evidence out before we perform. One was Donald Trump last fall, before he was elected, allegedly had ties. And a lot of those clips you heard from him, a lot of those clips came from him being questioned during that period. Then we find out that his national security advisor, Michael Flynn, had conversations with the Russians that ended up leading towards his resignation / firing. Then we find out that Jeff Sessions, who is the Attorney General, also had conversations, and he was able to get around some of those questions in his confirmation hearings. He's still got some issues, but you know, he may be able to get out of this perjury thing. Then we know the Secretary of State, and I can't remember the guy's name, but he's the one that heads Exxon, was known to be very friendly with Russia. He was given awards and stuff. Sessions was actually given a hero's welcome over in Russia as well. Then we find out that last fall in Trump Towers, Donald Trump's son-in-law had a meeting with Russian diplomat with Michael Flynn in Trump Towers. Now, I don't know about you. I don't know where you live, but if you live someplace, or if you own something, and you got people there, it's a good bet that you're going to know that they're there. Would that be a fair assessment?
That's a very fair assessment.
And so, my question is, what are your thoughts about this whole thing? I mean, there's many ways that I want to ask the question. I'm going to stop talking and let you talk.
Oh, wow. Where do we begin sometimes, Marcus? This seems to me getting caught up on a lot of everything. No, I did not vote for Trump. That's being that known right now. But judging by everything that has taken place before, during, and after these elections, it just seems to me, does it know Putin? It's like, it's kind of confusing. From where I'm sitting at, it's just kind of confusing because it's like, once again, I'm looking at a situation where it's like, they're trying to use the 52 fake out on a lot of everybody, and it's just separating everybody along these lines of on some end, have or have not. And once again, a situation where white privilege. I may be wrong for saying, but like white privilege is basically sitting at the forefront once again in the fact that we got, and maybe in some way, shape, or form, that they are making strange bedfellows with Russia. Now, does he know Putin? I don't know. I don't know. It's just kind of like, once again, listening to those clips, it's like one big contradiction. I know I'm missing some stuff, y'all, because like I said, a lot of stuff is like, once again, coming back to my mind as I listen to every piece of evidence. It's just looking at how Trump, knowing Trump's history and knowing how he is like, once again, another thing where it's like, it's just another flim-flam on the people without regard to our times.
Lee, you should know. Donald Trump, does he know Vladimir Putin?
Yes, he knows him. Get the... is that the one y'all can or can I say?
You said it, don't use it, but...
Oh, dang, that's messed up. I'm coming on all throttle first, is what I can say. Get the out of here. Are you kidding me? He knows him. This man has been getting away with lie after lie after lie. Lie after lie after lie. And it's like, we know he's lying, but his people, they're just like, we know he's lying, but yes, he knows him. He's already proven that he knows him. You think because you say, no, I don't know him, that means you don't know him? Really? He's already saying he knows him. He's already admitted to knowing this man. So now he doesn't know him because he said it. I'm sorry. Hashtag alternative Ooh. Facts. Fake hashtag news. Fake news.
Fake news. Fake news.
That's a great way to put it.
Yeah.
That's those hashtags.
Big bro Joe.
Yep.
Does Donald Trump know Vladimir Putin?
See, I was gonna say something crash, but I'm not.
I'm a listener.
Yeah, I was about to go loud. No, of course he knows him. He knows him, he knows he knows him, and you know what? America's not stupid, but we can do, or we're not doing anything about it. That's the whole thing in a nutshell. I mean, the games, in and of itself, are childish. To play on our intelligence as a people is stupid, but it is what it is right now, and that's exactly what they're doing. They're playing on our intelligence factor.
He got voted in because of that. These people, these Trump supporters, they know he's lying, but they won't say it. They won't. Good morning.
You know why they can't say it?
Because then they'll be admitting they were wrong.
Exactly.
And they'll never do that. Never.
I mean, but isn't the security of our country more important than that? I mean, this is a dude who has time to tweet about The Apprentice and time to tweet about Saturday Night Live, but we're expected to believe that he didn't know that his son-in-law was meeting with a Russian diplomat in a building that he owns. You know what I'm saying? Like, for me, that clip that I displayed would be more than enough, I guess, if I was a lawyer.
For impeachment?
Of course. But if I was a lawyer, I was going to say, like, reasonable doubt. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Clinton got impeached for something way less important.
Depending on who you ask.
I think it was less important.
Well,
funny that you make that analogy because Clinton lied. We know he lied.
Thank you.
They came back and said that he lied. He came back and rebutted, yeah, I lied. And it went on about his business. The 45th is sitting here
lying.
Once again, just trying to play on our like it's going to go away. I guess if I keep saying it long enough, it'll go away. And you know what? If I don't answer it directly, it'll go away. And you know what? The American people are stupid. And
taxes.
We're going to get rid of everything Obama did anyway.
I'm glad that you said that,
taxes.
Because I would be very curious. I mean, I've always been one that says show the taxes. And I'm curious to know if it's something in those taxes that would, you know, confirm the connection. And I think it may potentially be even more sinister than that.
How many other countries is he in league with? Business bedfellows.
Yeah.
I'm sure China is one of them.
China.
I think he probably knows North Korea too.
I, Probably. I'm sure there's some nations that he's trying to block their people from coming over here, but he's probably still doing business with the main players.
Well, you notice that the main country that most of the 9/11 conspirators
came from is not on the list.
It's crazy because most of the countries that are on that list ain't never done nothing to us. You know what I'm saying? Well, they took Iraq off the list. When they redid it today, Iraq wasn't on the list. So there's six countries. I can't recall them all, like Libya and Somalia and Iran. And
well, I can tell you, you know, what's funny to that is that those are the ones that are actually on the trade embargo list that when you're banking,
OPEC, you are getting you probably get a knock on the door.
Yeah.
The bank might shut your bank account down.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. I mean, I just, you know, the diversion.
Yeah, the bait and switch.
The diversion that comes up now when we try to accuse, you know, former President Obama of wiretapping. Like, what the hell is that about?
That was so dumb. Did he even respond? Because I haven't seen him say it. Has he? I think Obama said something like that.
A spokesperson, he said, nah, I ain't doing it. But, you know, the crazy part about it is, like, everybody who would know all said that it didn't happen.
Right.
You know, like, national security, former national security advisors, head of the FBI, CIA. Like, all of these people was like, nah, son, you tripping.
Go ahead with that.
Yeah, go ahead with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And so, I just, my biggest deal, honestly, y'all, is we have a large section of our country that is drinking the Donald Trump Kool-Aid. And those are the same people that you find yourself fighting with. You know, whether it be in social media or whether it be the clips that you see of these people screaming folks out in stores and malls and telling them to go back to the country and all this kind of stuff. You know, it's crazy to me the privilege that you have that you would walk up to a stranger that you've never seen before, whose story you don't know, and you would tell them, go back to your country. Like, my country is the country I'm in.
Thank you.
Yeah, real talk, because I'll tell you, go back to yours.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, you don't know my story. You don't know if I immigrated here. You don't know if I was born here. How dare you? You know what I mean? And I think the president, not directly, but certainly indirectly, has inspired this thought process.
Not directly. Sorry.
You can make the direct argument. You can make the direct argument. But I'm saying indirectly simply because these are people now, white nationalists, who feel inspired by some of the things that he's done.
They've been waiting.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, just think the irony that you have a large section of the country who thinks that George Bush got sense. Like, you remember how he was talked about 10 years ago?
Absolutely.
Whereas now, like, he actually is coming off like a jolly old granddad.
Yeah.
He's living and loving his life.
Have you seen him?
He was on Jimmy Kimmel the other night.
He was on Ellen the other day.
He's just laughing.
All he do is smile and laugh and giggle.
Glad he is out of this mess.
Yeah, and you know, it's sad.
And he's painting now.
Yeah,
they just adopted another dog too. Didn't they? I heard that.
Yeah, he's painting now, so he's a serious man of leisure and has found his artistic niche.
Yeah,
I'm impressed.
Yeah, you know,
I've never seen Barack Obama so well rested and so happy.
Yo, our president looking good right now.
Yeah.
And you know what, like you said, he ain't coming back. And he like, yo, y'all wanted
this? What you wanted.
You got it.
I mean, the reality is, America, y'all ain't got, we ain't got nobody to blame but us.
Right.
Like, for real. What, like, we mean? Did this.
Wait a minute. No, I didn't do this.
You know what?
I may have, because I was a Bernie supporter.
I mean, the reality is, we don't have to have. We don't need to rehash the old, but the reality is, if Hillary Clinton wasn't so arrogant, she would have taken Bernie Sanders and we wouldn't be in this mess.
And that I agree with 100%.
Yeah, we wouldn't be in this mess because the truth is, I didn't vote for her because I didn't like her either.
And Tim Kaine wasn't a bad...
Yes, he was.
Tim Kaine wasn't a bad...
Yes, he was. You know why?
Because he wasn't burning?
Because he wasn't burning.
No.
And nobody knew who Tim Kaine was except for those of us in the
That's it.
Nationally, this man had 20-year-olds losing their shit over a 70-year-old man. And they was going crazy over him. He looked like the Muppet from, you know, in the balcony.
No, dude.
That's what Bernie Sanders looked like. But you know what? You know, if we talking strategy and stuff, like, who knows if you can get the stuff that he was talking about. The reality is, he had the people riled up. And she didn't figure that she could, that she needed them. She strategically failed. And then we ended up with Donald Trump. That, and then of course the Russians helping with the hacking.
Yes, they did.
Because, you know, that's the story. But it's fake news though. So we probably shouldn't talk about it.
Alternative facts.
It's alternative facts.
Well, I got a fact for you.
What's that?
The 45th is a lie. Yeah. That's a fact.
Yeah.
He said it. Because if you say it, then you...
Well, you know how we know he's a liar? Like, we don't even have to debate the fact that we think he's a liar. We just play the clip that it says...
But he said he's not. He said he doesn't know. So that's what the answer is.
But what's the real answer, though?
He knows him.
Let's think about this, though. The businessman that Trump is, and let's not take anything, let's be real for a second. Let's not take anything away from, he's actually a true business dude.
Right.
Did everybody agree with me on that?
Absolutely. I think he's just taking I would say he's taking advantage of loopholes, just like.
That's true.
Why is that? That's shrewd, really?
Yeah.
I mean, well, when I'm being shrewd.
You're going to jail.
And you got far too much melanin for playing that kind of game.
You
can't be true. Yeah. You know, I mean, the reality is if you can flip $1 million into $1 billion, you got to be.
You're right.
Sort of kind of.
And still
file
bankruptcy. How many times? Eight.
But see, the thing is, I think the filing bankruptcy thing is a misleading thing because he's filing on his business, not on his
own.
But that's the smart thing to do. Back to the original point.
True. So think about it like this. If you're the shrewd businessman that you are, do you not believe that the president of the country knows you're in his country? I mean, we can look sideways if we want to, but one of the shrewdest businessmen out here right now is in your country, in your hometown, talking to other people. And you would tell me he doesn't know he's there and he's not going to pull a beef with it?
I'm going to use the adage, and maybe the host will back me up the house on this one, but you use the age old adage in, like, say, we harken back to like American cross-country pimping. You know, if that brother is coming in and he pimping in your city, then y'all not going to be there.
You're not going to be bros.
The reality is that's, you know, Maya Lansky and Lucky Luciano and Dutch Schultz and all of them.
That's essentially
what you just said.
Exactly. I mean, that's some real talk.
You know what I'm saying? And so, I don't know, man. Sometimes I feel like I'm beating a dead horse, but this is our ministry. Like, we have to
stand on
the mountain and scream to the top of our lungs to get folks to understand that this man is not good for our country. And if nothing more, he is going to taint our reputation and embarrass us. Because I saw an article in the newspaper, or online, I saw an article, and it was full of, you know how you have those political cartoons?
Yes.
It was a bunch of political cartoons from around the world. Not here in the States, but around the world. And they literally are laughing at us around the world because of who our president is.
Yeah, man.
Like, really?
Yeah.
They're about to get away with murder, literally. They can do just about whatever now. He doesn't care about the national security of America.
That's not what he cares about.
I don't know. He just dumped another couple of billion in the armed forces.
Yeah, he did. And he took it from social services.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And he also is going to take credit for the stock market increases.
Yeah. And he's also talking about how the deficit has gone down, even though we're currently still under President Obama's budget.
Yes. Play on words is a wonderful thing.
You know, it's like, come on, man. Like, you know, you don't get to do that.
Yeah.
I still don't believe he cares about the national security of this country. I really don't. I think, I mean, think about it. So he's giving money to the military. Who hasn't? I mean, of all the presidents, I mean, he's doing what everybody else is doing, but I don't think it's for our security, because if it was, all of his people wouldn't have been, you know, talking to Putin, and he wouldn't have lied about it.
Why are you scared to say Putin? It ain't like he was Putin.
I'm not scared. I'm just
Putin.
Talking, you know, slowly
if his middle name was Boris, his name would be Vladimir B. Putin.
And he looks like the dude on Rocky and Bullwinkle.
He does. Yeah. He does. Every time I see him, I think of that. Vladimir
B. Poop.
He's full of self, I swear.
Yes, so let me ask you. Let me ask you a question, Dee. Dee and me, I got a question for you. Right? If you at work, right, and you go to your boss's office, you think it's okay to take off your shoes and crop your legs open and start taking selfies of the people who are in the meeting with?
I can tell you, he would faint before I would. That thing, he's so frail.
Was your legs cropped open?
That was so unprofessional.
She
was a complete lack of decorum in the Oval Office.
Man.
Is that your deal?
Complete lack of decorum. It was disrespectful to the group that was there. It's just disrespectful to that. Why would you take a picture like that?
And
she knew they were taking pictures.
And then you're taking a selfie with your feet on the table. Oh, really?
Now, the devil's advocate, because I know I've been talking to the devils. The devil's advocate would say that she was asked to take that picture. To that, you gotta say what?
Say what?
I believe that.
Wait a minute. Well, to take the picture with her legs?
Yeah.
Oh, so her.
She was asked to take that picture.
I believe it.
I have not seen the selfie.
But my thing is
I haven't seen that.
There's a picture. There's the picture that's been floating around
with the HBCU presidents in the background, and she's
another,
on the sofa.
And then there's another picture of her with the phone.
Phone, right? Taking the picture.
I haven't seen that.
Yes. Does that change anything, me?
No, it doesn't change anything.
She could have easily just said, wait a minute, let me get myself together.
Exactly, I agree with Dee. Let me get myself together.
I'm in the Oval Office.
Thank you, and I said that before. You disrespected the Oval Office.
I'm not, it's not even about...
You're not in your living room.
Yeah.
You're not at Grandma's house. You're not at Uncle Ben, Uncle Jim's house.
You are
in the Oval Office.
You know what's funny, though? Because if you got your feet on Grandma's couch, she might snatch a
ball. Yes, sir.
I wouldn't take a picture with my shoes off in my grandma's house on her sofa either.
Okay. First of all, we don't get to sit on the sofa.
Thank you.
Still.
And she didn't even know.
That's what I was about to say. My grandma would have made that on.
That's that room. The living room, and
you better take your picture in the doorway.
That couch had plastic on it.
Still don't get to take
it.
I'm trying to drive home a point. Disrespectful. She could have easily have said, you know, wait, let me get myself. I would have. Exactly. I wouldn't have wanted to take a picture like that. No, let me, you know, look like something. Oh my goodness.
Well, think again. Look at.
But then look
the
at
people
her.
That she, yeah, that's what I'm going to say. Look at who he has around him. Certain people, first of all, if you don't know what your role is, if you don't know your role, I mean, if you trail upon, then you trail upon.
Okay,
you
wait,
do stuff
wait,
like
wait,
that.
Wait. But when they were introduced to the White House, and then, I should say, ushered into the White House, they have their assistants. They have
people that handle their wardrobe, their makeup, their PR. They have the PR for the PR.
Now you say that, and I think about her.
Okay. But did at any point did you ever see when Michelle Obama was doing any of her stuff when she was trying to get the kids to exercise, when she was trying to get the kids to eat healthier, being out in the garden?
They said, "How dare you?" When she did that.
Exactly.
When she had her shoulders
out. When she had her arms.
Just her arms.
Her very toned arms.
You would think that the people would aspire to be like her. You would think.
No, because that means you have to give credit where credit is due.
Yes, you have to give credit to this amazing black woman.
Something that they reluctantly do.
But you know what, though? I'm going to tell you something.
Okay.
I am very proud to walk around with my fist in my hand. Having said that, there are many opportunities, many times where there are certain situations where I don't even want to use the race card. Because to me, it's just too easy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's too easy. I don't want to use a race card. It's too easy. And this thing with Kellyanne Conway is one of them examples where, in my opinion, it's just too easy to use a race card and say that she's in this room full of HBCU presidents and she's disrespecting them. Like, I could think that, but I don't even really want to go there. I really want to go to...
I'm just saying there are a lot of black people who
that's what they did
in their arguments. That's directly where you're going, and I just got to the point where I don't like to use a race card unless it's really the only card there is to play.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, if that's all you got, then, you know, because I don't run from that discussion. But if there's other things that we can point out and discuss, then I'd rather do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, Donald Trump's a racist. I don't want to do that. Donald Trump's an asshole. There's a difference. Just because you're an asshole will make you racist. There's a lot of adjectives
right
in between them two. that do fit. You know what I mean? And so, yes, I called the President of the United States an asshole. I'm sorry, I did it. I respect the office, and I don't think he's an illegitimate president based upon the rules that we have. He was elected the president. But based upon the things that he's done, he's done some asshole stuff.
Yeah.
He just has. We played a clip of it a little while ago. You know what I mean? And for him to think that it's cool for her to be in there like that, I'll be honest with you, I don't think none of us check for Omarosa to be up in the office like that. Could you imagine? Honestly, let's play the race card for you.
I don't think she can do it like that, though.
Because you can say what you want about her, but she got class.
She got class. Yeah. First of all, she's not going to embarrass herself.
Exactly.
They got nothing to do with Donald
That's
Trump.
Her.
She's not going to embarrass herself to give anybody the room to be able to talk about.
But let's just play this game. Let's play race card. If she did, could you imagine?
It would be slaughter. Saturday Night Live be going off again. I mean, that would be the worst than Bill Clinton. That would be worse than Bill Clinton.
And she would have been fired immediately.
In Europe.
Did y'all hear what Don Cheadle said this week?
No.
No.
Oh, man, I'm about to drop a bomb on y'all.
Okay.
All right, so Don Cheadle and someone, anybody, pull your phone out and Google facts behind me. Don Cheadle said that a friend's father, the friend is a famous white female famous, he didn't say actress, he just said famous. A famous white female friend of his, that person's father was playing golf with Donald Trump years ago. Wow. And Donald Trump asked this guy if he ever F-word and N-word.
Oh!
Oh, wow.
And he apparently felt comfortable speaking this way because in his mind, that's how we talk. Apparently, he said this in front of a white dude that don't get down like that with regards to speaking of other people this way.
Who said it? You said Trump said that?
Trump said that. President Trump said this to another white man who happened to be the father of one of Don Cheadle's friends.
Okay.
And this person was highly offended. The article that I read didn't allude to, and I'm going off the dome. If one of you guys have it in front of you, please fact check me. But apparently this guy ain't about that life where he thinks it's okay to talk this way. He didn't check Donald Trump, but he ain't rock with him no more after that.
I'd have checked him.
In a bizarre series of tweets, Don Cheadle claims Donald Trump used racist slur with friend's father. This is People. Yesterday, 2:50 p.m. A Twitter rant, actually.
Yeah, but it's kind of unsubstantiated. I mean, not saying that Don Cheadle has any reason to lie.
Yeah, as he say, she said.
It's hearsay, so which is inadmissible in court.
But we're talking about the guy who did say that he wanted to grab her by the pee.
Yeah, but we heard him say that.
And we heard. Yeah. So
I'm not surprised. I wouldn't. I don't doubt that he said this.
Do we think it's illegal? We don't think it's illegal.
Well,
I don't think it's illegal.
It's not illegal.
I don't think it's illegal.
No. We find different ways to break down our president. And you know, a friend of mine who is a Donald Trump supporter. Yes, we can be friends because he supports him. So what? We're going to be grown-ups here. Just because he supports president doesn't mean I'm not going to be the guy's friend. Like, seriously, let's be grown-ups. But he did challenge me to say something positive about Donald Trump. And I said, his daughter's smart. That's all I got.
Yeah. Man, that's fair enough.
He has little hands.
That's positive.
Depending on what you're trying to pick up. If you need to get in a tight place.
I struggle because reality is I don't like Donald Trump. I don't support him. You know, I think that we would be unwise to hope he fails. You know, like the Republicans said when Barack Obama was elected, you know, we want him to be a one-term president. Well, anytime you got a one-term president, that kind of reeks of failure. You know what I mean? Like, the whole point of being the president is to be successful. And so if you don't get your whole two terms, it's probably because most of the country didn't think you did a good job, and you probably failed. The last two I could think of was the first George Bush and Jimmy Carter. And so with Donald Trump, you know, if I'm in an airplane, I'm not going to say I don't like the pilot. I hope he fails. Because if he fails, I'm going to crash in that plane and be dead.
Yeah.
Well, in this case, if Trump... Wait a minute, you said if he fails. I mean...
I don't want him to be around any more than the next person. However, it would be unwise, in my opinion, to root against someone who is leading you, whether you like them or not.
But why would you say that?
Because
where is he leading you?
Because, don't misunderstand what I'm saying. What I'm saying is we need to have positive things come out of the presidency, or else we all fail.
Okay, right. That's different.
Well, that's what I'm saying, though.
But you're assuming something positive. He's doing well. Back to my question: what is he doing positive?
Well,
what
is
he going to do? He's not moving towards anything positive for this country.
Well, we still got a long way to go. I mean,
look what he's done already.
No, I got you on that. But I guess the point that I'm making, and maybe I'm not articulating myself very well.
No, I get it now. We shouldn't root for his failure.
Because it's bad for us.
Because it's bad for the country.
It's bad for the country.
They're already laughing at us.
Around the world.
And if he fails, how does that make us look? You know what let's just use North Korea for 1 second. If he fails, then what would North Korea do if he started to fail? If America is not showing the strength and the prowess that we know that we have and we're supposed to have, and we're undecided about things that we're going to be doing, and we can't articulate how we're going to do these things, a lot of the stuff that we do is scare tactics. And if you can't scare them without pulling out that bomb and pushing the button, I don't want him to have to sit there and put it in his hands to turn that damn key.
I don't think he's going to have a problem with that. He seems rather, this is what I want to do, so this is what's going to happen.
Oh, he's not going to shy at all.
No, he's still a punk when it comes to certain stuff. Business, it's a whole lot different.
Well,
in business,
that's what it is. If he has a business relationship, nah, he's not going to mess it up. But we don't know what his business relationship is with North Korea because
show
he doesn't
taxes.
See his taxes.
Yeah,
I mean, he ain't got elected, but the people who really elected him were not the majority of the people who. Yeah, we want him. Are the people who don't even keep up with that kind of stuff? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, the reality is, and you know, Trump's Donald Trump supporters, translation, white folk, get mad when you say this. But the reality is, smart people didn't vote for him.
I don't believe that. It's
true.
There are white people who are smart that voted for Donald Trump. Listen to me. Follow me.
The exit polls show, and this is something that you can look up, that the lower your education and the less smart you are, the more likely you're a Donald Trump supporter and you voted for him.
I understand that. You can make numbers say
the higher your education, the more education that, the smarter you are, the less likely you voted for Donald Trump.
I can create a poll to make that number say what I wanted to say. And I believe that. I believe that. But what I'm saying is there were some educated people who voted for Donald Trump.
I'm sure there was some dummies that voted for Hillary Clinton. I got you on that.
Yeah, we're not saying that they weren't smart people. They were a lot of educated people who did.
Yes.
But the majority of the people who fell for Donald Trump's bullshit rhetoric were the people that are about to lose their affordable care. They hate Obamacare.
Like,
but you know what? I mean, to your point, Donald Trump got more black people to vote for him than any Republican president.
What?
Since Reagan, actually. Yes, it's a fact.
Yes.
Yeah.
More black people voted for Donald Trump than any Republican in like 30 years.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's a fact. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
I was in the gym doing
the yesterday. Are you kidding me? What poll is that? Who did that? Nonsense. Oh my
goodness. It's
It's true.
You know what it is for Donald Trump though, Ty? Because he's a businessman, he's convinced a lot of people that he's going to be good at jobs. And jobs is where people are really touched. They want to get back to work. And so as a business person, this is where, you know, like, I give you a perfect example. Like, somebody like me, I'm a novice when it comes to, like, real estate and stocks and all of that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I don't really get it, understand it, all of that. But as a person who can look at a situation and analyze, to me, I look back at the last two Republican presidents, and I look at, I'm including Donald Trump in this, and I'm looking at what's important to them. Donald Trump's a businessman.
Yes.
He creates businesses, and he creates real estate. And so if you buy land, you're probably going to do all right.
Yeah.
And you're probably going to get a job if you need one because he's going to build some shit. Back to George Bush. He was an oil man.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And what happened to gas prices when George Bush was the president? They skyrocketed.
Right.
You know why? Because he took care of his people.
That's right.
So it don't take a genius to figure that stuff out.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you look at Donald Trump, I'm going to tell you something. If he makes it through and doesn't get impeached, he might just get that second election.
You know what?
Absolutely.
Based off, you're right. Because he's bringing a lot of the production jobs back. That is a positive thing to say about him. I will say that.
But even though he's bringing the production jobs back, does that necessarily mean that's going to favor hiring people to do those jobs?
That's the other thing. Yeah, he's kind of forcing them. You want to work overseas and not pay American people, then you're no longer going to get these
tax breaks. Right. So you need to bring the job back to the United States.
But you're right. They got to start hiring.
You want to get rid of some, get rid of NAFTA, because that's what started all this.
Absolutely.
That's what started all this. I don't want to call on my cell phone per company and talk to, you know, Amir in India. No disrespect to Amir in India, but I don't want to talk to you.
No.
I don't understand you. I don't want to talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And you're in India. Why am I talking to you? I want to talk to Tyrone in Atlanta.
No, you don't. Tyrone can understand my plight.
No, he can't.
But I can talk to Tyrone.
But I can have a conversation with him and not go, huh?
But what you have to understand is, after 9 o'clock, Tyrone's not available anymore.
Oh, that's true.
So why not?
This is West Coast time.
Right.
But it depends on the company that you call as well. Not everybody has a 24-hour call center. They tell you that you can reach them 24 hours.
The reality is, man, we as Americans, we so screwed. we really are. We just so screwed. And it's largely because we have an apathetic appetite towards always going to the polls. We only go to the polls every 4 years, and then we ask help, and we forget about 2 years from now. Now, what's going to happen is you're going to see a Trump backlash in 2018, and a whole bunch of Republicans are going to get voted out, and the Democrats are going to get the House and the Senate back. Right?
We can raise our hands, you can say we
and all of that stuff all you want, but I don't give a shit about them either. They're perfect people, wolves and foxes, both dogs, and they gonna bite you. They don't care about you no more than Republicans do. So let's be clear. Independents and libertarians. That's where we need to be.
And if all they people have to do is just vote for them, man. But you know what?
And not only that, they have to vote in every election.
This is what I'm saying.
I'm talking about the 4 year, the 2 year
primary.
I'm talking about we've got local elections coming up in what, July?
Dog catcher.
I think the city of Richmond does have local.
I think the problem. I mean, and I said
it's,
this.
It's a couple elections coming up real soon, June and August, I do believe. I'm sorry, June and August.
I said this in the fall. You know what I mean? I did not like Hillary Clinton. And I went to the poll and I literally did, because I knew that not voting for her could potentially give us Donald Trump. I knew it, but I just couldn't vote for her. I couldn't do it. I could not do it in good conscience. And I think it's unfortunate, because there were a lot of people like me.
Oh yeah.
There were a lot of people like me. Now, we are off the hook because she did win Virginia, but still, you know, the Republicans and the Democrats are simply not for us. And what I was saying, back to the original point that I was going to make, is this two-party system is really, you know, there has to be viable candidates from other parties to give people more choices that would make the blood and cuz work harder.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Like a libertarian. I know, I voted as an independent, but I know based on my spirit, I'm a libertarian. I said this I got something to say on the table on show a couple of days ago. I'm that dude that thinks that you should be able to go to a gay wedding with your pistol in your pocket, smoking a joint.
He put it all together.
He said it to me.
Yeah. And you can battle.
A unisex bathroom.
A unisex bathroom.
There you go.
Yeah, because I mean, the outhouse ain't that a unisex bathroom?
No, absolutely.
Why are we tripping? Right. You know what I'm saying? It's like,
man, the mindset of folks, man.
You've been going to porta potties at the jazz
and
festival.
And didn't know they're unisex, did you? Mm-hmm.
You ain't know.
Oh, you went the whole time. It's just like, look.
You know what I'm saying? You flip the switch, the moon gets full, everybody's in there.
Yeah. And you
the moon is half, it's open. Come on.
And it's going to the handicapped one.
Yeah.
Exactly.
It's cleaner.
And bigger.
Exactly.
I'm not a handicapped one.
Thumbs up.
I pray nobody, no handicapped person comes in that bathroom.
I want to be that day. I want to clean your bathroom.
Yes.
I'll pay you $5.
Just had to
go. Yeah. No trouble.
I just had this conversation with my son yesterday. He's in AP World History. And my parents were bugging because they're like, why is he talking like this? I'm like, these are the kind of conversations my 17-year-old, my 14-year-old have. And I have to sit there and talk to them and listen to it. And I get engaged with them. But they both said, why is our system so different than, you know, the parliamentary system or some of the other government systems where it's not just one, two, you only have these two choices. People in other democratic places, their votes really count. there is no electoral college to count these votes towards that particular candidate. That's their whole thing. And I'm like, you know, this is where we live, babes. Mommy can't afford to move overseas somewhere else. Sorry, but there, and the kids are talking about this in class. It's major. It's very interesting, especially now with this Trump debacle. That's what I call it.
That's what we can call it. We just saying peace to our brother Solo on radio. We're losing him, but much love. Be safe, brother. Yeah, it'll have Steph and Marcus J live from the den. Legacy Internet Radio celebrating our 4-year anniversary. 804-402-2893 is the number to dial. Celebrating the 4-year anniversary of Legacy Internet Radio. Thank you, everybody, for rocking with us. We are going to, I mean, we can actually talk on the subject like all night, but we're not going to. We're going to take our final break of the night. When we come back, we're going to close it out with our rants, and we're going to close it out with our closings. I will have a word of history, interesting piece of history that I'm going to share. Some of you know it, some of you don't. Hopefully, it gives you something that you can take. And of course, we will have a missing child. Everybody in the room will have an opportunity to rock on. You're listening to the flagship show, Legacy Internet Radio. Ain't no half step on Marcus yet. We are live from the den. Still no more. Be back in a few.
This is classic. Get at my dude, Marcus J, on Legacy Internet Radio. Ain't no half step. Get your own JW mixtape. Hit me up. Jody Smith on Facebook. Jody Music, J-O-D-Y Music. Or you can hit me up on Instagram or Twitter. They're both Jody_804. Get at me on.
so there's no excuse for missing the airing of the 40th anniversary of the show. Time for me to do our history moment. And in September of 2011, three friends got together, actually in August, three friends got together and decided that they were going to do a radio show. The lead of the show was a guy known as Jay Grizzy. Jay Grizzy called his friend Carl Banks and said, "You know what? I need you. You're my brother. I need you." And Carl Banks, of course, you know, really, he said, "Yeah, man, I got you. I'm going to do it." And Jay Grizzy and Carl Banks said, "You know what? We need another guy. You know, somebody who is a straight guy. Somebody who can kind of keep us in order." And they called it yours truly. And they said, "Marcus, you want to come up and be down with us?" And I said, "Sure, man. Absolutely." Carl Banks is the medium, middle guy, because he's my friend and he's also Jay Grizzly's friend. I had known Grizzly, but, you know, we got known through Carl Banks, not his real name. And it's funny, too, a little piece of trivia that I don't think I've ever shared this on the air, but my original radio name wasn't Marcus J. I remember there was a day when we were in the courtyard of Tycoon, of the place we used to be.
Yeah.
You know, with respect to those folks, we won't say the name on our show, but you know where we were. Shout out to the guy that ran that place, because if it wasn't for him, we would be here. But we were outside in the back courtyard in the parking lot, and one of the guys there was a DJ. And his name was DJ MJ. My name was gonna be MJ. But there was a DJ named DJ MJ. And I said, "Yeah, I changed. Can't do it." And so I said, "Well, shoot, what am I gonna call myself?" "Well, shoot, I don't know." And I went with the simple Marcus J. So back to the history. After about 3 months, you know, Jay Grizzy gracefully bowed out of the hosting duties of the Green Room and turned it over to yours truly, who had gotten the bug. And we rebranded the Green Room to AMI7 Marcus J in December of 2011, where we continued the show for the next year plus until the end of February of 2013. And on that last night, on a Monday night, we finally got to the end of where we could go with that location. And I said to Big Roo, who had replaced Jay Grizzy on the show, I said, "Are we going to continue the show?" And he said, "Yeah, we're going to continue the show." And I said, "Well, what are we going to do?" He said, "I don't know." I said, "Well, independence is the key to building a legacy. We should probably do our own thing." And he looked at me and he said, "Legacy Internet Radio." And I looked at him and I said, "That's it." This was a Tuesday. This was the Tuesday before March 4th. In the next 6 days, Big Rube and Marcus J went in our pockets. Because we didn't have no money. We ain't had no company. But in the next 6 days, we created an LLC. We bought a computer. We bought a mixing board. We bought microphones. We had everything we needed to launch Legacy Internet Radio. Everything except a place to be. And that place to be ended up being where? Big Rube's Kitchen. Big Rube's Kitchen. And I remember being there the night before on Sunday, March 3rd. I was nervous as hell. But Jay Grizzy came and he said, "What you need, man? I got you." This was the person who put me on, coming back, and he allowed me to put him on. And this is where it comes full circle. And Jay Grizzy, the first night, a month later, in April of 2013, when we got enough money to actually get a place to be, knowing my affinity for big cats, and in particular lions, He said, man, we live from the dead tonight, man. I said, word. That's what we're going to call the studio, the dead. And so when I say that this ain't never been about me, I mean, this ain't never been about me. It just hasn't been. Every single person who has come into this room, and it's the new dead, but it's the real dead. But every single person who's come into Legacy in that radio has been important. We started off with three people. And now we got honorary members. You know what I mean? You know, we got sisters who come and call. We got audio visual people. We got co-hosts of other shows. We got brothers who will come in here and not even ask you what you need. He just knows what you need, and he does it. You got brothers calling from Atlanta, Georgia. You got first ladies who put you on to the group that came in here earlier, because we wouldn't have even known who that group was if it wasn't for the first lady of Legacy in that radio. That's her contact. We're group effort. And I appreciate you guys for being here. I appreciate you guys sharing my vision, because it ain't just mine, it's ours. And so I just wanted to recap those folks who may not have known those bits and pieces of history, because I do Black History every single month on every single week on AMISF with Marcus J. And I know that kids gonna be reading about us in the history book. That's our history group for tonight. Ain't no half step with Marcus J. Live from the den of Legacy Internet Radio. I'll have a word later on with regards to my rant and my closing. I know you thought that that was it, but damn it, it wasn't. I still got more to talk about. I promise you my rant will be very short. It will be as short of a rant that I've ever done tonight. But at this time of the show, we always profile a missing and or exploited child. Tonight's no different. We're looking for Trevon Allen. He's been missing since February 27, 2017, which is about a week ago, last week, from the Cap City in Ryko, VA. And Ryko, of course, for those who don't know, is a suburb of us here in Richmond. 15-year-old black male. He's 5'7", 130 pounds, black hair, brown eyes. Last seen on February 27th, he's got black hair with red streaks. If you've seen this young brother, Trevon Allen, please contact the National Center for Missing and or Exploited Children on their website, missingkids.com, or contact the Henrico County Police Department at 804-501-5000, or contact 1-800-THE-LOST, 1-800-843-5678. You know, I said, Mark, yeah, I'll get to my thank yous here momentarily, but I want to give everybody else an opportunity to speak. I'm going to shut the hell up for just a few moments while my brother Ty Cool, my sister Dee, my sister Nene, and my brother Big Bro Joe close it out with their rants and their closings. Our honorary member of Legacy Internet Radio, Ty Cool, is going to lead us off. My brother, what you got?
My brother. Wonderful show tonight, wonderful vibe, as always, and just wonderful, just glad to be here. Nothing of a rant tonight, y'all, but do just keep in mind, everybody out there, when you tune in to this show or any show on Legacy Internet Radio, be ready to be informed, be ready to be entertained, and please know it's not going to be your run of the mill. That is something you can't put it in a bottle. And I'll say it again, you cannot put it in a bottle. So when you log on, no matter where you are, with Legacy Internet Radio, you're gonna get a family vibe, you're gonna get something that you were not ready for. That's me for tonight, y'all.
My brother, appreciate you, man. Appreciate you. Of course, I'm always glad to see her when she comes home, in her home, my sister Dee. What you got, sis?
I do have a rant. I'm going to try to be brief. For those of you who like to post these serious topics religion, for example, that which is what my rant is about. Don't post something that you're not prepared to get the responses for. I've had a couple of conversations, or I guess discussions on Facebook recently about faith and beliefs. How can we as a people believe in the Bible, Christianity, da 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 da? Like I said, I'm gonna keep it short. If you wanna go there with me, don't get upset with the response. Simple as that. I'm not about just reading one book. You gotta do your own research. You talk about people who, we talk about history books and how they don't report or discuss everything. It's the same thing with the Bible, I'm sorry people. It is, it's been translated, it's been misinterpreted. Do your own research, that's it. That's all I'm gonna say.
I can date my sister Dee Dee. This room is missing you, so you know where we at. We here every Monday. So make your way, come on home. Whenever you're here. We appreciate you. Ain't no high seven markers. Jay is happy to bring the co-host up. I got something to say. You hear it every Saturday afternoon at 2:30, right here live from the Den of Legacy Internet Radio. I'm gonna give her flowers here in a few minutes, but my sister Nick, what you got?
Hey. I do have something to say though.
Shocker.
An interesting fun fact.
Shocker.
For those who like Coca-Cola, did you know that Coca-Cola would be green if the coloring wasn't added to it?
What?
Really?
Yeah, really nasty, huh?
Interesting.
Did you know that your sneeze travels 100 miles an hour?
I learned that from my daughter when she was like a baby when she threw up on me.
That's not a sneeze, that's vomit.
Is it vomit?
Projectile
vomiting. That's what they call that.
And I think that's fascinating.
And lastly, I've been on this workout kick, mostly you all in this room, you know about me now trying to, you know, be fit and fabulous. But I have learned that you burn more calories sleeping than you do watching television.
I knew that.
So that means get your butt up off the couch.
And go to bed.
And go to bed.
I can't do it. I have a hard time doing it.
I can't sleep working out.
I have a hard time doing it.
And he's working out.
I grew up when the man was going to say CT Fletch. I'm going to tell you something, all right? I'm going to tell you something. First Lady Legacy in that radio works us out.
Yes, she does.
She works us out. And
you tired already, just think about it.
Yeah, yes. She's like the best personal trainer.
She is.
I see those folks.
We've ever seen. And yeah, nobody does it like
We put in some work, y'all.
I see y'all. Hey, I'm like,
hey, I owe y'all one to get out there, too.
Tired looking at y'all.
You owe us three.
Yeah, you owe us
three. Okay.
Yes.
So we've been in Amon Park.
Uh-huh. Pony Pasture.
You know, so far, we're supposed to Point Fashion twice, yeah. And we're supposed to do,
Libby
Hill Park. The steps.
The steps.
What's that? Churchill, right?
Yes.
Yeah. The steps.
I might have to join on that one. I got a wedding, bridesmaids dress.
Man, I mean, I would be shocked. She had us clowning Mount Everest or something.
We done done that.
We done
that. And look over to the other side.
We did that in
Mount Everest. Oh, glory.
And wait a minute, Marcus. We climbed a couple of trees.
We did climb a tree.
Yeah, we climbed trees.
Yeah.
We climbed trees.
I'm not coming.
We hopped the wall.
Yeah, we broke.
We jumped over a brook.
Yeah, we jumped over a brook. We did.
We jumped over a brook.
We ran from a bull.
Yes.
Hold on. That's fine. Hold on.
Yeah. He got a scar. What you doing?
I was checking my heart started racing again, man. You understand?
What? Joe almost had a heart attack.
I did.
Yeah.
Marcus pushed me up the hill.
And pushed him up the hill. Hey, I got one for you.
What's that?
AOLP. How many more stairs I got? 17, baby girl.
Yo, I'm looking up there.
17.
So you can imagine what it's going to be like at Libby Hill.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, but I've done them.
But it's been a while
But I'm going to tell you something about Libby Hill Park. I mean, I can tell you how many steps it is from top to bottom.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell you how to run up 153 steps. What? From top to bottom.
And
up and down is one. One.
Yes.
Up and down is one.
Yes.
That's right. I ain't working on y'all. Yeah.
First lady had us doing jumping jacks,
squats,
lunges. I like squats and lunges. I can do that.
Yeah.
No,
we spoke,
but push-ups. you don't know when you're gonna have to do them though. You know, you could be walking along and you're like,
stop. Give me 20.
And you'd be like, okay. And you do that joint too, because you don't
play.
Yeah.
At 40 past, I know we did about 500 jumping jacks and about 500
pulling past.
Squats in one
set
series. It was ridiculous.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
It's already in my mind.
Yeah.
It's already in my mind.
We outran the snakes.
I definitely will be doing that.
We call
them
snakes punks.
Yeah. We told
them
to do a jumping jack.
You know what? It gets in the other direction.
I think they were scared of us. They were scared of us. They heard her barking at us. And they were like, no, we're not messing around.
Yo, old people were sitting up and looking at us like, you all go.
Yeah. How many, the old lady with the cane?
Cane. Yeah. She had to be about 95.
She had to be.
Yeah.
Wow.
She was out there walking though, so if she didn't get out there and walk, right.
Yes, Dee. But the true part about it was we had even the dogs feeling sorry for us.
Yeah, the dogs were
looking at us like, I wouldn't be you.
You ain't tired?
No time, boy.
It's crazy. Ain't no ass to have fun, okay? Live from the Den, Legacy Internet Radio. Last but not least, before you, it's truly Big Bro Joe.
Yes, sir. What I got has nothing to do with what we talking about anything tonight. What I got is Restaurant Week here in the RVA. And I'm fat. And before Lissa, the comedian that's Mr. P, kills me on next Sunday, I'm going to eat the next 4 days.
Yes.
So if you want to see Big Bro Joe of Legacy Internet Radio on tomorrow, after I got some business to take care of, I will be at one of the local spots eating.
What's tomorrow's spot? Didn't Coach Reggie McAvoy ship, my God, all those names. I'm sorry.
Did she say
that? Sorry, Reggie.
Yeah, she did.
That's called all his names.
Yes, she did.
He ain't even here.
No, but he said the Reapers are going to be somewhere tomorrow. Girlies.
Yeah, it's Girlies tomorrow.
I've never been there.
You remember? They had good food.
They do.
Wednesday is Caribbean Day, so I know Chef Malusa is going to be there. And then Thursday is Biggie Day with Kelly and Lonnie B.
I think Saturday, our brother
AJ is going to be at
Yogurt Park.
Yeah.
So we got to do that too.
Yeah. We got some yogurt?
No, I'm volunteering.
Right.
I'm gonna volunteer to stand out there and tell them which space they
want
to
see it.
I give him supreme props because, you know, he's an alumni, you know, to Legacy Internet Radio. He's opened his doors at Brewers Cafe a couple of times to allow us to do our shows live. But I thought you were big brother.
Oh no, that's it. You know, like I said, AJ is like, he's alumni of Legacy Internet Radio, and we always want to make sure that we are supporting black businesses. Brewers Cafe.
Yeah, check them out.
1511 Bainbridge.
1125 Bainbridge. And don't say Avenue because the first show, I kept saying Avenue.
I think it's the Bainbridge Avenue.
Yeah, 1125 Bainbridge Avenue.
You know, that's that Jersey thing.
It's Street.
You don't have Avenues?
Yeah,
it's
not
a
Bainbridge. But
it's not, I don't
think it's a Bainbridge.
Oh.
It's a street.
But
they have the best chai tea ever.
I
took a picture of it and everything. Google's like, would you like to share this? Yes, I would. It was delicious.
And he even does the phone with the little, he does the, you know, with the coffee, the white phone.
He wouldn't run that thing while we were on the air. Right. And everybody was like, can I get my tea? I was like, dang.
Ain't no ass that remark to Jay live from the Den, Legacy in that radio. Get some thank yous in. Our sister Bryna is listening to us, and I love her because she always is on it. And she sends us notes to our Facebook pages and all of that kind of stuff. And she's a longtime listener and supporter. She said that she loves all the hip hop playing during the breaks because, you know, I've been moving in the hip hop mood tonight. And so she's digging it. So I appreciate you, sis. And I appreciate you listening and supporting. Get some thank yous in. Michelle K, our brother Gene checked in. People who came in to the room. Our sister S.Y., our brother Tavon, our brother Solo, all came in. Of course, our brother Kato called up, and he was part of the show. Special thank you to Anita and James Lawson, who were both in the room tonight. Of course, they were, they're the parents of one of our sisters in Waiting for Silence, who were the live band we had here for the very first time. On our 4-year anniversary, we had a live band here, live in the den. And so very, very happy and honored to have them. I appreciate our brother Hakeem, who checked in, of course, and our first lady of Legacy and the radio community, that's Lisa Peters in the room with us tonight as well, fellowshipping. Special thank you to our sponsor, Free Spirit Enterprises, our sister, Arthur Charisma, who is our data pool dealer who joins us on the fourth Monday of every single month, is also a Legacy and radio sponsor. And our brother Sid, what up, bro? Who's sitting a foot away from me tonight, he's usually listening to us. He is our Legacy and that radio sponsor. He takes care of our apparel and our shirts, and he makes sure that we be fly up in these joints. And so Facebook Live, you can see my shirt. Him did that. Him did that. Him and whatnot. And, you know, just put him on camera. Yeah. He ain't want to be on camera, but he ain't know I was going to do that. But I'll probably pay for that later. But I still got him on. So thank you for that as well. You're listening to the flagship show, Legacy on the Radio. It's called Inner High 7 with Marcus J. On Tuesday nights, you hear live radio. Wednesdays, you hear Joint Body Radio with our sister Ashley Joy and lately Big Bro Joe. On Wednesday also, you have Absolutely Alphas. On Thursday, All Throttle Radio. On Friday, you've got the Woke Squad. And on Saturdays, you've got I Got Something to Say, followed by the Bob Marley and the Family Reggae Mix. All night, taking you on a Sunday morning, when Amplified Gospel picks up before Irreconcilable Differences with Big Rude. And then Twa After Dark. Joining us in April, you've got Couch Coach Live, which is a sports show. That's very personal to me because we started off here doing the Green Room, the original Green Room, as a sports show. So to know that a sports show is coming back to the airways of Legacy Internet Radio, which we've never actually, well, actually we did. We had Clutch, the sports show. But it didn't last very long, and that was something that Big Boot was doing, and he didn't do it for very long. So I know that our brother Couch Coach comes to us with a pedigree and a legacy because he'd been doing it on another station, and he has honored us and blessed us with his presence here. So I look forward to that brother bringing that to us. You're listening to the 4th year anniversary. We're going to be celebrating all month long here on Legacy Internet Radio, the flagship show, Ain't No Half Stepping with Marcus J. And it's time for me to close out the show with my rants and my closing, which is going to be very, very, very brief. I just will just say this. I remember telling my closest friends and confidants last fall that 2017 was going to be a big year for us here at Legacy Internet Radio. I didn't know why. I just knew I felt it. And we are doing it together. With our largest numbers ever in January of 2017, to our studio makeover here in February of 2017, to the debut of our TV show in March, on March 17th, right here on Comcast and Verizon in Richmond, Virginia, Friday nights at 6 p.m. here locally. We are realizing that dream and that feeling that I had right here in the first quarter. We are rebranding. Legacy Internet Radio and Legacy TV are now part of Legacy Media Group. As I mentioned to you before, We started off with three people, and we now boast a team of over 30, and we are growing. Remember the name, Legacy Media Group, and watch us work. That is the Murr. Marcus's unrelated rant that ain't got nothing to do with what we ain't talking about. It's the end of the show, y'all. I want to remind everybody that independence is key to building your legacy. I also want to say peace to all the stars and all of the squares. To the abundance of water, who is thirsty. Those are the words Bob Marley, who we are singing in the background. And you don't have seven or Marcus J, where we air in its entirety, immediately following this upload. Happy Prince Hall Day. Be back next week. Peace, y'all.
Thanks for rocking with us. Come back next week, please.
She played basketball.